Hey there, guys. Welcome to the channel. So Tucker Carlson just said something that surprised and shocked basically everyone that watched it. Before I show you that, guys, thank you so much to everyone that's been subscribing, everyone leaving such great comments. Really appreciate the support, guys. If you haven't already, help us to continue to grow. Like, comment, subscribe. Most importantly, share the channel. Really does mean a lot. So can you guys ever remember in our lifetimes an election that we weren't told it's the most important election of our lifetime, the most consequential, most important, most historic? If we don't get it right this time, we won't have a country left. They literally gaslight us with this every single time. And by they, I mean both sides do it to themselves, to their people, for as long as I can remember. And honestly, when you look back, you know, through the years, in a lot of cases, with all things considered, it was probably true. And I think, you know, because of all the times in the recent past, especially, that we actually really, really did screw up our choices as bad as we possibly can. And, you know, I think with everything going on in the world right now, everything going on in our country and with our government, that hyperbole has never been more true than it is right now. And I think Tucker Carlson explains this better than anyone I've ever heard.
I'm only saying that to highlight what everyone in this room already knows, which is that it's really a volatile moment. I flew out here across the country this morning and spent 5 hours texting people, mostly people I know, but also the entire mentally ill community in America has my text, so a lot of crazies too. But also a lot of people I really like and who are smart and temperate and reasonable people who've been around, who are my age, I'm 54, you know, kind of seen stuff and have measured opinions on things. And I gotta tell you, every single person I texted with the exception of my wife, who's not on the internet at all, was angry and paranoid. Seriously. And these are not crazy people, these are normal good people with like kids and stuff, with a vested interest in Americans' success. These are not the burn it down caucus. These are the, you know, these are the people you want voting. And they were all angry and paranoid. Every single one of them, some of them really angry and some of them really paranoid. And I have to say, after assessing their views for 5 hours, I think they were justified in both. I think they had every reason to be angry and all the evidence required to become paranoid. And so I'm not mocking them at all. I'm just telling you once again what you already know, which is this is going to be, the next year is going to be, I think I'd bet my house on it, really like nothing we've ever seen in the country. And everyone can kind of feel that. You know, most of our perceptions come through intuition rather than reason. And if you have dogs, you know this, because they can't understand literally a word you say because they don't speak English, hardly any of them. But if you're close to your dog, you know the dog knows exactly what's going on, knows when it's time to go out, knows when you're going on a trip. Why is that? Because they don't hear anything, they just watch and they feel. And people are very much the same. And if something bad is about to happen, everybody gets jumpy. And everybody's really jumpy right now. So I'm not here to, you know, make your anger and paranoia worse, just the opposite. I'm here merely to suggest a couple of things that I think you could do about it and that might be useful rather than pointless. Like spending a ton of time on social media screaming at people. Well, obviously I do that for a living. And I would never discourage anyone from doing it. You know, probably aren't going to solve your problem. So here, the first thing I think that's really important as you stare down the next 12 months is to accept the fact that that all your senses are telling you the truth.
Yeah, so you see that. I mean, guys, let me know in the comments what your initial gut reaction to that is. And honestly, you know, I think, you know, quite a lot of people are justified in feeling paranoid. If they are feeling paranoid, I think they're justified. You know, people in this country, they really are struggling, man. You know, people are really having a hard time making even just the basic ends meet. You know, record numbers of our friends and neighbors are visiting community food banks. Record numbers of families are racking up credit card debts that they feel they're probably never, ever going to get out from under. And these are just purchases made for necessities. They're not doing frivolous spending. And on top of that, people all over the world are dying in wars that powerful people are exploiting and continuing, you know, long past when a resolution was possible. And, you know, it's all because our current presidential administration, they have been a complete and total disaster. Maybe it's not all because of that, but that is a major, major factor. they have been a disaster in basically every measurable way. And it's costing many people, you know, it's costing people more than they ever imagined, more than they ever bargained for. And it's not getting better. You know, the president just had an 81st birthday, and none of this is getting better with age. The man is not like fine wine, I promise you. And as much as I hate to say it, guys, and as tired as you all are of hearing it, this really is the most important election that we've probably ever had in our lifetime. Not just in our lifetime, probably of all time. And, you know, not for the reasons that the propagandists of the Democratic Party have convinced their poor victims of. You know, democracy is not at stake. Democracy is not on the ballot. Our entire country, our entire way of life, that is on what's on the ballot. You know, democracy is not on the ballot. Survival is on the ballot. But guys, that's just my take. Let me know your take in the comments. It's depressing to think about. Guys, if you haven't already, guys, like, comment, subscribe. Most importantly, share the channel. We'll see you in the next one.